Sound America. It's Derek Soto here from Sinestra Studios, the ideal music journalism spot. And we're here live at Lincoln Center in New York City, and we're doing our first episode of Bloodlines. And our first episode is a big episode, because I'm just going to put it to you like this, Battle Cross Destroyed. You know, these guys went on stage full force, and, you know, they opened up with a couple of good songs, you know, not bad for 25 minutes, 25, 30 minutes tops, I would say. Lighting was, on par. It wasn't spectacular, and I'll tell you why. You know, from a photographer's standpoint, you know, I do all my own work, so from a photographer's point of view, it just was not fun to shoot. It was really difficult. And three reasons. One, you had the high stage compared to the photo pit floor. That's never fun shooting straight up. You always have to shoot back if you're working on a wider stage floor. And that was a pain in the ass. It was a huge pain because a lot of the band members had to come up towards you. Now, when they come up towards you, there's no shadowing to remove any type of complexion shadows or facial shadows that come on. It's completely dark. So that just results in high ISO speeds. I mean, it just was not a fun shoot. I've had better shoots with them at Irving Plaza when they've opened up for Guar, or even at Mayhem Festival 2013 when I first met them. Those were better shoots, and those were better photos. But, you know, for the Paramount out in Huntington, Long Island, this was a first time. I expected a little better, you know, considering it. The set list comprised of many of their favorites. They played, you know, Push, Pull, Destroy. They played My Vaccine. They played Breaking You. They played classics, you know. I think it was an 8-song set list. And Kyle Gunther's always on point, you know. Gumby's a maniac live on stage as a lead singer. He always manages to keep the fans on a swivel because it's never staged. It always feels natural for the guys. You know, guitarist Tony Aston, Heron D, they always come up and they keep their own character on stage during the performances. And so, you know, you get a lot of goofy faces and you get a lot of, you know, tongue showing and just, you know, pumping up the fans. It's always a nice thing when they do that. And then you got the Lox, you know, Don Slater, the bass player. I love Don. Don's always going to be one of my favorite bass players. To date right now, he's one of my favorites. He's one of my top. The kid could bass his ass off. Bottom line. And, you know, when you get a full package like that, including Shannon Lucas right now, you know, Shannon Lucas on drums. I don't know if you know Shannon Lucas, ex-Black Dahlia Murder. X All That Remains. The kid's unstoppable. You know, he's been touring for about 8 months now, 8 to 10 months right now, and it's been taken to another level. Now we did a nice quick interview with Heron D backstage at the Paramount. Check that out right now. Let me know what you think about it. Top three questions on the board, and hope you guys enjoy. We'll be right back.
My name is Derek Soto. This is the first episode for Bloodlines, Season 1, Episode 1. And I'm right over here with the Sultan of Shredding, my boy Heron from Battlecross, Metal Blade Records. Heron, what's going on, man? How you been?
Dude, great, man.
Doing good?
Yeah. Things are good, man. Just fucking enjoying the time on the road as much as I can, and then enjoying time at home. Obviously, we're out here constantly, so.
I kind of noticed that, I mean, the sheer amount of tours you've done has been ridiculous in the past couple of years. You know, you guys just finished World Protest Hero. You know, you did the thing with Killswitch in Europe. You got Grass Pop coming up right now in Belgium over the summer. You got Download coming up.
Yeah.
I mean, what haven't you done yet that you think you haven't done yet? I mean, considering all the tours in the past 3 years.
There's a lot of countries we still got to hit. Japan, Australia, all that stuff. So hopefully that happens next year. Right now we're just we got obviously Europe coming up in June, and then we got the first time South America.
You'll be doing that with Memphis Mayfire,
and Killswitch. So that's gonna be awesome. I can't wait to do that.
It's been a blessing right now seeing, you know, you guys tour with Killswitch. It's been a while on top of that. I mean, you know, you did the tour last year. You know, you're doing it in freaking. Europe, and I get here again with them. Yeah. It's like, it's a good luck charm.
It is, man. We're very thankful for those guys, for them to bring us out and give us the kind of exposure that's been helping us a lot. You know, from Trust Bass America, you know, going out with them and Five Finger Death Punch was huge for us, especially as a breakout band.
That was the last time, God forbid, actually.
That
was the last time you guys played with them too.
Yeah, for sure. And you know, and then doing that, and then being able to go over to Europe, you know, like the first time, you know, I can't imagine that most bands going into Europe for the first time get to do such a big tour like that, Killswitch and Trivium. I mean, that was huge for us.
Right, of course.
Those guys, and so that was a big foot in the door for us and a big push for us. So we're just thankful that they're just, you know, keep inviting us out. So I mean, I'll never turn out of those guys.
That's the bottom line. Now, when it comes to Sirius, I mean, that slays me, because you know, you had your first three singles from the first album, from Push Pull Destroy,
yep.
You know, 2011. You had the first three singles on Sirius for over a year.
Yeah.
You know, and that's remarkable coming out from, you know, a band that's obviously, you know, you guys were starting out then. You were just getting noticed by Metal Blade.
Yeah.
You know, so that was the big deal. You had to push for it. You know, all your singles that come out, you think that push after that, no pun intended, that push was actually, you know, a big boost for the current album? Or, like, how do you think you could pass that?
Well, you know, I think Sirius number one has been a huge, huge part of these tours that have happened, the exposure that's happened. I mean, we owe it a lot to those guys, for especially Jose, for pumping us up. And I mean, you know, the amount of listeners that listen to Liquid Metal and really kind of get their metal source from there, because obviously radio isn't the same. You're not going to get the kind of metal bands that you hear on there compared to satellite radio. So, you know, when people listen to Liquid Metal and become diehard fans, and they listen to Jose, when he's pumping something up, you know, he pulls in those people, and that really pushes us.
Your fan base has brought in vastly.
Yes.
Vastly. I mean, again, all of it is coming full circle, all the tours are going to be stateside out of Europe, you know, so that's massive. I've noticed it. This is my, what, fourth show with you guys.
Yeah.
Seeing you guys, you know, doing press. This guy is getting old on me, really, but it's been four times. Can you name those four times? I mentioned one.
Yeah, Guar was one.
Guar.
Mayhem. Death Angel?
Okay. Yeah, not Hatebreed, Death Angel.
Okay, that's right, Death Angel. So I'm assuming this is the fourth?
No, there was one more.
Was there one more?
Yep.
Damn it.
There was the off day at St. Vitus in Brooklyn that you played with
right.
A mattress.
Okay. Sorry.
Yeah, that was the one. Yeah, no one remembers that one. That was also with my other brothers in Rivers of Nile. They
nice.
Also opened up that
yeah.
show too. So big props to them. I miss them so much. But I know you guys are going to plan to do the next album, obviously. Do you have any probable potential covers that you would like to do? I mean, as from a guitarist point of view.
We've got something coming. I can't say it.
There's something coming, though.
We're in the studio recently, so there'll be a song coming out. Can't tell you what.
Don't worry about it.
You'll know about it soon enough. So.
That's good. That's good.
As far as the next album goes, we're very focusing on. We're actually trying to take July and August off, some weeks in there to focus on writing and kind of, you know, unwind from you know, the road, from being out there so much, and just try to focus on some new stuff. So that's why, you know, we're doing Europe in June, and then July and August will kind of be open, other than, you know, South America, and then we're doing something in the fall. Can't say what yet, of course, but
I will come back for that.
But there's another tour coming up around then, so we're trying to, you know, not oversaturate the U.S. market too much, and you know, also just focus on writing and kind of get in that mode. So, you know, we want to have something out by next summer. You know, so
yeah, of course.
That's kind of our mentality. Like, push out the next record and do all the things all over again.
Exactly.
You know, so.
And my last question that I gotta know. I mean, considering the fact that, you know, it's going on a year since Force Man has come out. And I mean, number two on the Sirius chart, number 134, Billboard 200. I mean, that's great. How do you think you can push yourself further to actually, like, you know, break further into Billboard? Because I mean, I see a lot of acts, you know, come and go, and they do their thing, and they always land somewhere that's in a stellar spot. But I mean, you know, from me to you, I want to see you guys hit that Billboard top 10 badly. I mean, like, how do you think you could be able to push yourself and the band to do it?
Like, that's where the pressure lies, man. I mean, that's, you know, it's like third record. You kind of have everything in place to give all the right people and necessary tools to push your record. But it's ultimately, at the end of the day, dude, it's up to the band to put out that solid material that's like, this is a great record. All right, let's push this. You know, we're building this fan base now. We're building our audience. We're back, you know, going over to Europe at least for the second time now. So now we have more of a bigger audience to.
And you have a bigger festival to follow.
Right. Yeah.
As well.
So now it's all on us, man, to go out and make the best thing that we can do possible. We have to outdo Warwood.
Yes.
You know what I mean? We have to outdo that. So there's that pressure, man.
You got classics on the belt, and I mean, it is very pressure.
There's a lot of pressure, man. It's a little scary too, but at the same time, it's like, you know, it's all or nothing, man. Like, we can't do anything less than that. We're not gonna put out anything less than that. So it has to be awesome, and that's why we're so.
You're just killing it.
Yeah, you know, and that's the thing, man. And that's our mindset. Is like, we can't go out and do any less. So, you know, when we take tours and we plan things, it's like, you know, you're basically kind of planning your career as far as what's next. You're kind of laying out what you need to do.
You just gotta keep it going.
Yeah, you gotta keep it going, but you still have to have a mindset of like, okay, we can't do this tour in the summer because we need time to write.
Exactly.
And if we oversaturate ourselves with touring, what are we gonna do when it comes time to deliver a record and we don't have the material we need? So we need that time to be creative and relax a little bit and focus on that. So. It's definitely in our mind, but you know us, man. It's gonna come hard. That's our thing, man. You know, it's like the mindset of just going out and kicking ass and doing our thing. You know, we're not gonna try and do something different. We want to sell more records. We're gonna go in this direction. We're gonna do our thing, but we're gonna make the best fucking thing possible that we can put out.
Their way. That's it. Their way. Plain and simple. Ladies and gentlemen, live from the Paramount Long Island, I'm here with Haran from
Battlecross.
Goddamn right. This is Bloodlines. Keep it tuned.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is all the time that I have today. But I want to say thank you to Haran from Battlecross for the interview. And I want to thank the band itself for putting on such an amazing show as they usually do. I want to thank my camera woman, Susan, behind the camera right now. She's working it diligently and tolerating with me. If there's any other work that you would like to see, you can go on our website at www.sinestrastudios.net. You can also check us out on any social media website, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and Flickr. You can check us out there. Also check us out on our YouTube channel as well. So until then, I will see you guys on the flip side. Peace.
What's up, everybody? I'm Tony from Battlecross.
Here on.
I'm Don.
And we support Sinestra Studios.
Sinestra.
Fuck you, Derek.
Fuck you.
I just had to throw that.